In this session, let's learn about shade pool. Shade pool is another important memory structure of your system global area. Shade pool contains your library cache, data dictionary cache, results cache, and some other memory structures to store your parallel execution message and control structures. Okay, the three important memory structures of shade pool are library cache, data dictionary cache, and results cache. Let's learn about library cache. Library cache is one of the important memory structure within the shade pool. The library cache is so important because it has the shared SQL area and the private SQL area only if it is a shared server configuration, and it has got the PLSQL procedures, functions, and packages executable code sitting in the library cache. These shared SQL areas are accessible to all the users. That is why this library cache is sitting inside the shared pool. Okay? Now, let's learn about the shared SQL area within the library cache. Okay? Whenever you run a SQL statement, Oracle database allocates a shared SQL area and a private SQL area for each SQL statement. This shared SQL area will contain the parse tree and the execution plan for a given SQL statement. Example, here we have three users and they are running a SQL statement. That is why we have three server process, and you see each user got his own private SQL area. You see three private SQL areas. And since Oracle determined that all these three SQL statements are similar except the values, here it is 10, here it is 20, here 30, that is why it said, why allocate three shared SQL areas? Since the SQL statement is the same, I will just allocate one shared SQL area and will reuse for all the user processes. Since just the values are different, those values are stored in the private SQL area. You see 10 here, 20 here, and 30 here. And the common SQL statement parse tree and the execution plan is stored in the shared SQL area. By doing this, Oracle database is saving the memory, right? Yes. Suppose example, more users are running the SQL statement and there is no space in the library cache. Oracle database will deallocate the space for some of the SQL statements by using the least recently used algorithm. Okay, it deallocates so that the new SQL statements have enough space in the library cache. Okay, if a user is executing a SQL statement and if that SQL statement is found in the library cache, then Oracle database need not do any parsing. It can directly execute. But if the execution plan of a given SQL statement is not found in the library cache, then Oracle database has to do the parsing, generate the execution plan, and then run the SQL statement. Okay, that is why it is advisable to have good amount of library cache so that you can store a lot of SQL statements execution plan. Okay, so the next one is your data dictionary cache. This is another very, very important memory structure within the shade pool. We know what a data dictionary is, right? It is a collection of database tables and views which contain the metadata about the database, its structure, and the users present in the database. Right? Example, what tables, views, synonyms are in the database? What packages, functions are there in the database? And what is the code associated with these objects? What users are there in the database and to what objects they have access? Like this, all the metadata related information is stored in this data dictionary tables. Okay? All those data dictionary tables and views are stored in the data dictionary cache. Oracle database uses this data dictionary very frequently, almost for executing every SQL statement, it has to use the data dictionary. That is why data dictionary is stored in two places. One copy is maintained in the data dictionary cache and the other copy is maintained in the library cache. Okay? The third important component of a shared pool is results cache. The results cache stores both the SQL query result and the PLSQL function result. That's interesting, right? Yes, whenever a user runs a SQL query, the results can be cached, that means stored in the memory. If the same SQL query with the same parameters is run by the same user or a different user, the database can just retrieve the answer stored in the results cache without re-executing the SQL query. Right? What does this lead to? It leads to tremendous performance improvement. Example, if you say select count star from customer and if it returned a result of 10, now that 10 is stored in the results cache. Now, if some other user executes a similar SQL statement saying select count star from customer, it will not re-execute that SQL statement. It will say, oh, I have already executed this before. So it will go to the results cache, fetch the 10 value and return to the user. Okay? What does the user needs to cache the result in the results cache? The user can use the result cache hint to tell the Oracle database to store the result of the SQL query. Or if you want to store the results of all the SQL queries, then you can set the result underscore cache underscore mode initialization parameter. Okay? Apart from these three main memory structures, you have some other small memory structures within shared pool to store your parallel execution messages and control structures and also some locking information. Okay? We can define the total size of this shared pool using the initialization parameter shared underscore pool underscore size. Okay?